You know the kind of guy that drives to cut down Mercury? You know what I mean by the angry Marty? You know what I mean by the angry Marty? Not the friendly Marty who goes to little friendship dances at night and moons at school teachers, but the guy who goes around, puts nickels in the jukebox over in the Jersey car joints, you know, and sits around in the drive-ins and hollers out at people. And when, if you ever catch his eye, he turns around and says, "What, you want to make something out? What are you, wise guy? You want to make something out of Mac? What do you want? All right, what are you looking at? What are you looking at, Dad?" You know that kind of guy? Well, all right, he's sitting there. See, this is the angry Marty, who hasn't made it with a chick in 500 years, unless he's belted her in the eye. And this kind of guy, he's just sitting there, big clunk, and he's got this sateen jacket on. It says something like 14th Street Saber Jets or something, you know, on the back. And he's sitting there, or Charlie's Tavern, I think it said something. He was an ex-softball player. And he's sitting there at the end, and he's clomping down a big hamburger, and apparently he's ordered another one. Well, there were a couple of empty stools, and sitting then was a guy in one of these gray uniforms, you know, the kind of uniform that a guy wears when he's a night watchman or something. You know, this gray shirt and the gray pants and the black belt, open shirt, and he's got the sleeves rolled up. And he's a guy about 60, maybe 65, white hair, thin white hair, and he's wearing big, thick, horn-rimmed glasses, and he's got no chin. He's roughly 5'3", maybe 4". And he's sitting there, and he's eating. And sitting next to him is a girl, just a girl. She's sitting there, see? And she's one of these girls, you know, who has her hair cut real short. She's got a butch haircut, and she's wearing, she's got on blue jeans, and she's got a white man's shirt, and she's got a real deep voice, and she's sitting there, and she's wearing a pair of what looks like GI shoes. You know that kind of chick? She's sitting there. And next to her are a couple of nondescript people just sitting there. Now, the whole thing is going fine. I walk in there, just sitting there. Well, about 3 minutes before that, I had been walking along the street, and I had passed this bum. And he was one of these, he was a staggering drunk kind, you know. His shirt has been torn, the shirt tail is hanging out in back, and he's walking around, wait a minute, buddy, you know, that kind of, he started standing there with his legs spread apart and his arms sort of hanging like great big meat hooks on either side. And his head is going back and forth like an elephant. Hey, baby. You know, that kind. Well, I passed him by. I went on down the street. I go into this place, and I'm going to get some coffee. So I walk in, and I'm the coffee I want to take out, see. So I walk into the place, and I say, Give me a large coffee to go. I want it black, please. And so the guy behind the hot plate is the one that was taking the outgoing orders. Oh, okay, Mac, okay. All right, just wait a minute, Mac. So there was dead silence. And suddenly the door opens behind me, and who staggers in? He stands in the middle of the floor with his hands hanging. And he sort of weaves back and forth, and the big guy at the end just kind of looks over his shoulder, just looks at him, and goes back to his hamburger. Well, I pay no attention because he's one of those drunks that you got to keep from catching his eye, you know? If you catch his eye, you got trouble. He wants to come over and put his eye. Oh, Mac, you got a quarter. Give me a quarter. Give me some money. Some meat. You know that kind? So I'm looking out of the window, paying no attention, and suddenly I see out of the corner of my eye and in the reflection of the glass, he has sat down next to this old guy. The guy with the gray suit, you know, the gray work clothes. He sat right next to him. And there he sits, you see. Now he's between the big guy on the end and the old guy. And next to the old guy is this chick with the short hair. You see, she's sitting there paying no attention. She's drinking coffee and looking tortured. She's just looking straight ahead at the menu, tortured, you know, that kind of look. And suddenly I hear the guy with the gray suit say, "Look," he said a very precise tone, "look, why don't you just get up and leave me? Why don't you just get up and get out of here? Don't you see that you're just causing all kinds of trouble? Now leave me alone, will you?" He says to the bum. The bum has obviously turned on him. He's, and the bum goes, he turns and he looks at the other guy, and the guy says, "Come on now, get up. Well, then suddenly, the guy at the end of the counter gets up. And you can see that there's a little altercation breaking out between the bum, the drunk, you know, and the old guy sitting there with his gray suit, who looks like a very straight old guy. And the drunk has begun to shove this old man around. So with that, the guy gets up. Obviously, he's going to be a good guy here. He just pushes the two apart, and he says to the drunk, "Now look, leave him alone, will you? Now cut it out. Cut it out, will you, Mac?" And he turns, and he sits down. With that, the old guy leans over the counter, and he says, "Will you mind your own business? What do you think you are, wise guy? What do you think you are? Oh, you big lunk. What do you think you are? I'll knock you flat. I'll knock you flat, Mac." The big guy puts down his hamburger, and he looks down the counter. "What is this, you know?" I said, what are you talking about? What are you talking about, bud? "I'll knock you flat. You think you're pretty tough, don't you? Ha ha, pretty tough." And the little guy is looking out from behind his glasses. All of a sudden, he looks like a sparrow with an impacted beak. All right, wise guy, I'll knock you flat." With that, he gets up. He gets up and he walks around the drunk, who's just sort of sitting there going, "Wah, wah, yeah." He gets up and he walks over to this guy and he says, "You think you're wise? I'll knock you down. Tough, who you think you are?" And he turns around and sits down again. Well, by this time, I thought, uh-oh. And the man behind the hot plate is working twice as fast. Now, shh, going, he's making a coffee, he's paying no attention. Shh, glug, 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 I hear it going back there. And the other guy's at the other end of the counter just looking straight ahead. One guy's eating the Danish, the other guy's drinking the coffee, you know, everybody's saying. And with that, the chick turns to the old man who is on her left, and she says, "Now, take it easy, will you? Why don't you just sit here, drink your coffee, and take it easy?" This was the voice of reason, apparently, coming in. "Just take it easy." And with that, the big guy at the end says to her, "All right, you," and a fantastic word he laid right out there on the floor, "look, baby, you stay out of this or I'm going to knock you down, too." And the next thing I know, all three of them are standing there. The chick's between the old guy, who is about 5 feet 3 inches tall. This is true Walter Millsville. He has been seeing too many John Wayne movies. And the big guy, who could have killed the whole crowd just with one big swipe of his paw. He could have knocked down the coffee urns and everything. He's standing there, and 6 feet four of them, 250 pounds. He's looking down. What are you talking about, baby? Who are you talking about? And with that, about 9 college kids are walking past, you see. And one of the college kids is what they call the scene maker. He looks in there, you see, and he sees immediately that there's a scene going on here. And college kids automatically these days are on the sides of drunks. Automatically. They're on the sides of drunks or you know, what they think is always the downtrodden. So he sees this going on. The drunk is sort of shoving all three. He's up now. And nobody's paying any attention to him. With that, this college kid comes rushing in. He doesn't know what's going on, you see. And by that time, I got my coffee, and I'm trying to get out. With that, the college kid comes in, and he walks up to this big guy, who's 9 feet tall by this time, and standing all real big. He comes up to this guy, and he says, "Oh, what are you trying to do? Are you trying to push these people around? Come on, you're trying to push..." And that was too much for this guy. Here was this guy. I must say he was innocent. With that, he reaches out and he grabs this college kid by his Columbia T-shirt, lifts him up off the ground. The kid is foot and a half off the ground. I mean, all Jack Kerouac'sville of him. The guy turns around, he flings him out in the street, and he goes out in the street and he looks around at the 9 other college kids. He says, "All right, is there another one around here who wants to do something? Huh? All right, which one of you now?" And at that point, the drunk comes staggering out and starts to hit the guy on the back. And the old man comes out with his glasses gleaming. The chick with the short hair comes out, and she starts to get... And this whole milling is going on all around. It's right out of Nathaniel West, the whole business. And I cannot tell you what happened then. Incredible. A midget came in. A midget who's not over 3.5 inches tall comes in with a woman who is at least 9 feet tall. And she is saying to him, "If you don't cut out, if you don't get off my back, I'm going to go off my skull. Now shut up, will you?" And he says, "Look, one more crack out of you and you're going to get it in the eye." And I walk out and I go staggering down the street with my coffee, and I have seen it again.